As an architect who's been at this energy intelligence for 30 years, I understand enough to be dangerous. But what's interesting from what I've understood in reading online about OEM and the algorithms, you're taking something that's very complicated and dynamically creating efficiencies. So talk a little bit about how that works.
In practice, the different components of the chiller system do not necessarily work well together, kind of do not work in sync. And by using an algorithm to optimize how they operate well together, we are able to achieve substantially increased efficiencies. Our technology is based on the fact that there are major parameters that influence the consumption, the energy consumption in a chiller system. These parameters all interact with each other. So what we do is to optimize these different parameters so that we can achieve substantial reduction in energy in the chiller itself. The chiller's energy consumption is primarily in the compressor, and that depends on the ratio of the outlet pressure to the inlet pressure, P2 over P1. So if we reduce P2, then we can substantially reduce the energy consumption of the compressor, which is about 80 to 85% of the chiller's energy consumption. And that's what our algorithm does. It takes into account the external conditions like temperature and humidity, and the internal requirements for the load, which is the cooling requirements by the user, and adjusts the condenser water entry temperature and the loading on the chillers in such a way that they operate as close as possible to the manufacturer's specification. And we do this dynamically and continuously.